Hello YouTube, it's me again, No Skills Man. I'm gonna present you today how to make a very easy jewel thief without winding coils, without toroids, without, you know, how many turns, how many that, you know, a very difficult, very easy one. We're gonna use for this project these, I think they're called inductors. You can find this in old TV or in old computers. Old thing is basically the same but with the same windings, the same number of turns. For this project in particular, I'm gonna use this one. I don't know, it's labeled something, it's quite small and it's got four pins, and basically this part is gonna be the primary and the other one is gonna be the secondary. To be very careful when you're gonna hook up the leads, basically this one, what I'm sewing here, is wind like this and it's ending here, and this one is the same, starting from here, winding to here. So basically we're gonna connect two opposite windings, the first of the second one with the second of the first one. We're gonna hook it like this. That's basically it with the inductor. And after that we're gonna follow the diagram here. So basically this is the power supply, the battery is going into the winding coils like this. The other one is gonna connect to the to a potentiometer thing. And after that it's gonna go to the base of the transistor. The other coil is gonna go to the collector of the transistor and the pin of the LED. In this case we got a 12 volts LED. And after that the emitter of the transistor is gonna connect to the other lead of the LED and to the minus of the battery. For this project we're gonna use the simple transistor 2N3055. As I said earlier, for this project we're gonna use the 2N3055 transistor. We have here diagram of the transistor. Basically this is the way it's represented in the circuits, and this is the actual thing. It's got two pins and two holes. Basically if you're gonna look at the transistor from this point, you're gonna see the leads, the two leads is not on the half, the exact half of the transistor, it's a little bit up. So basically from left to right we're gonna have base, the red one, emitter, and any other on the chassis is gonna be the collector. So base, emitter, collector, like in here in the diagram, base, emitter, collector, in a diagram, base, emitter, collector. Okay, so let's start it. We have the two leads connected like on the diagram. We're gonna connect to the positive of the power supply, which is the red, like this. Other connection of the inductor, we're gonna follow the diagram, is gonna connect to one side of the potentiometer. It's gonna be this side, like this. The other side is going to the base of the transmitter, or the transistor, sorry. So we said that base is the red one because I hook it up like this to be base, and emitter to be black, and to know to connect it to the positive, to the negative side. Okay, we have connected one. The other connection is gonna go to the LED. In this case we have a 12 volts AC LED, but I think you can use a 12 volts DC, or doesn't matter, this is very cheap, so I'm gonna use it for this project. So we have one lead connected, the collector and LED, so three connection to this part, very easy. That's it. And we have one more to put it on the other side of the LED, the just like this. And we're gonna connect the minus and hope. Yep, it's working. You can see the buzzing thing. Look, it's here, it's lighting. We're gonna adjust the thing. Come on. Look, we're gonna adjust it. It squeaks more, but the intensity is almost the same. We're gonna adjust it. No squeaking. Oh, it's off. Again, squeaks, and that's basically it. That's it. You have a very nice Joule Thief without no winding, no turrets, no nothing. Just a simple one, an inductor for free, a battery, an LED lamp, and a potentiometer. We have now connected the multimeter to see the actual milliamps. What's consuming? Come on, that's it. Bad connection there. Okay, we have 0.15 milliamps, 15, 14, that's the way it is. We can adjust it, come on, adjust it, just drawing more, that's it, look more, and now less, 14, 13, 12, that's it. Yeah, so it's not consuming that low energy, but it's a very interesting project. You can use it on various things. Very easy to make, like the other videos of mine. They are very easy, very honest, and that's about it for today. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to thumbs up, subscribe, and see you to the next time. Thanks a lot. See you. Bye-bye.